What's up, fam? It's that time. Sorry we're running a couple of minutes late tonight, but y'all, you know this Chef Gloriousness is a business, right? And we're doing big things. Got a little tied up in some business dealings, guys. We're running a few minutes late, but that's okay because it's all about getting Chef Glorious out there. Welcome to Calabama Cooking, you guys. It is live cooking Thursday, and your girl is excited. Y'all know how I do. You know I talk a lot, and that's why I'm so thankful y'all love me anyway. All right, so few things, guys. First of all, I'm getting going over here, YouTube fam. First things first, I want you all to, yes, share the video. I knew you heard me. I knew it because we're on the same page. We here. You know what I mean? Share the video. Next thing I want you to do, as always, please shout out those cities and states. I know y'all might get tired of the city state thing, but let me tell you something. I love it. And you know why I like it? Because I love seeing where you guys are, and I love having the opportunity to just, if I'm going to be in your town, to at least say I'm going to be in your town. I don't know. You know? All right, guys. Thank you so much over here. Facebook, YouTube fam, love you, Facebook fam. You guys, tonight we are making a dessert. I love when we make desserts, because desserts make everything better, and we're doing a chocolate dessert tonight. We're going to make my ooey gooey caramel chocolate brownie, okay? That's it, the brownie. I love this brownie because it is, let me tell you something. When I told the kids we were having, Mommy, what's for lunch tonight? I told them. They got so excited. You know what my little Aiden said? Is that dinner? Is that dinner? No, little man, it's not dinner. But it might be a summer, school's out. Okay, so we're going to start off by doing, I have to melt the chocolate. First things first, the recipe is actually already on my website, so I'm a step ahead of the game. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're going to start with a stick of butter and a cup of chocolate chips, okay? And you're going to put that in your microwave and melt it. I'm going to keep talking while it melts. Now, remember, when you're melting these things in your microwave, don't put it on high and like let it go crazy. That's not a good thing to do, because if you do that, what's going to happen is it's going to almost overcook, okay, and you're going to get things that you don't want. I start mine at about 30 or 45 seconds and at about 60% power, okay? So I'm going to let this go for 45 seconds at 60% power. I'm checking out, you guys. Hello. And then we're going to mix it up really good, and we're going to get going with adding our things together. We're going to actually make two types of brownies tonight because I'm just in that kind of mood. I feel like chocolate or brownie is what's needed, okay? So while that's melting, I'm gonna melt the next one here in a second. I'm gonna talk to you about both brownies at the same time. We're gonna do my regular chocolate caramel, and this one is a caramel butterscotch toffee brownie we're gonna make. So in this bowl, I have, again, one stick of butter and a cup of chips. And what I want you to really get from that, oh, this is perfect. You see how this came out? You see how those came out? That's how you want it. And then I'm going to do the same thing over here again, 45 seconds. Actually, I'm going to do these a little bit lower, 50% power. Okay, you see how this came out? And you're going to start, I'm going to whisk it together. The reason you want to do this part first is because you're going to want this chocolate to cool a little bit before you add it to the egg mixture. Otherwise, you'll have scrambled egg brownies. And that ain't cool. There's nothing cool about that. You see how easily this is whisking together, though, now that I've melted the butter and the chocolate together? And this is actually how you make chocolate syrup too, guys. If you want to make your own chocolate syrup or something, do the same thing. And you just keep whisking it, and the heat from the butter will finish melting the chocolate. See that? It's not hard at all. And what I want you to notice about this recipe is that as you cook these, now I'm going to see if this is good on this. See, this might be a little bit more. I turned it down to 50% because you got to be careful sometimes when you're melting the butterscotch and the caramel chips, because they don't always act as like the chocolate acts. So you just adjust it as you go. And it's not, you can always go longer. You can't back it up. You know what I'm saying? You can back a lot of things up, and you can back that thing up, but you can't back this thing up. I'm gonna put this back in here for a little bit longer. Remember that, you can always go farther, you can't back up. So I'm going to actually this time do 15 seconds at 60% because it's almost done. And the base of this brownie, whether you're doing chocolate, caramel, whatever, is a stick of butter and a cup of your chips. So just keep that in mind, and that'll help you be able to do whatever it is that you're trying to do. Make sense? Okay, I'm looking. Somebody called it naughty food. You are absolutely right, except we're all good girls here, so it can't be naughty. Okay, see here? Oh, my mommy made Look, that's that mommy made. I'm acting like my kids are in here because school's out, they've been home. Y'all, school just got out. Who's ready for school to start back? No, I'm kidding. I love my babies. Okay, see there? You see how I'm whisking this together? And I'm being very gentle with it because I don't want it to go flying everywhere. But now that I've got it going, you see how the heat from the butter is finishing off melting these chips? Oh, perfect. Yahoo! Okay, so while we let these cool, we're going to mix together our dry and wet ingredients so we can be prepared to add this to it. And the reason, like I said, I did this first was to give our this mixture a chance to cool so that we could not scramble our eggs. Okay, so while these are cooling, because these are nicely mixed, we're going to go over to our ingredients here. Now, we kind of have three stations. I set it up as three stations, right? We have our dry ingredient station. I'll bring it here so you can see it a little easier, okay? This is our dry ingredient station. This is kind of our wet ingredient station. And this is our decorative, we'll call it, or the extras, or whatever, okay? So what you're gonna do, I've got two bowls going. You're gonna start by mixing two eggs, okay, in each one, okay? Same basic recipe. I want you guys to see how simple this is. And you're gonna put a half a cup of sugar, okay? This is a quarter cup measuring cup here I'm using, and I just put a bunch in here. It should be exact, but I wanna make sure I get it right. Quarter, yep, it's exact. They did it right. I should have known. I have the best team. Okay, all right. Then you're gonna add some vanilla. Today I'm using vanilla paste. You guys know how I love my vanilla paste. You want to do about 2 teaspoons of that in each one. Now, as well, remember, you can change this flavor here, and you can put, you can do whatever you want. You know, you can put coconut in here. I have coconuts. You can, I mean, you can do really anything. Now, this is our wet ingredient station. And again, sugar is not wet, but the sugar is needed to help the egg come together. See that? See that? I should have probably used one of my bigger whisks, because it's going to get pretty full. But we'll get to that in a second. There we go. Any questions you have along the way, remember, always ask. It is my distinct honor and pleasure to answer. Okay? Same thing over here. Vanilla, eggs, and sugar. This is our wet station. All right. And then once this is nicely mixed together, and again, you don't have to overdo it. You're making a brownie, but you're just trying to get these going, get these talking to each other. I'm going to add the last of this little bit of sugar because just... they measured it perfectly, and you know, it's my control issues making me like, well, if it's not exact, you know. No, good and well it is. You guys, summer finally came. It's finally hot. I'm so happy. Okay, there we go. So now that we have mixed that together, does that look good? You guys with me so far? You with me? I can't hear you people. Are you with me? I'm looking. I'm looking. Okay, so now what we're going to do is go to our chocolate. So again, here's that chocolate we mixed up. See, it's cooled just a little bit. You don't need a ton of cooling. But I want you to see that when you're mixing chocolate and making chocolate desserts, you know what makes a chocolate dessert even better? Coffee. Yes, honey. These are, let me get this here. This is instant espresso, which means as soon as it hits that liquid, it's basically gonna dissolve, okay? Now you put, I put a teaspoon or so of that instant espresso in there. Hold on, Facebook fam. Something happened. I got to pause, so I can't quite talk to y'all right now. But that's okay. We're going to keep cooking. You add the coffee in there or espresso, and that really does wonders to bring out the flavor of chocolate. I don't understand it. I'm not trying to figure it out. But chocolate and coffee, them folk get along. I'm serious. Them folk get along. Okay, so you're going to add the chocolate here, and you see why we let it cool? Because we did not want these eggs to scramble in this hot chocolate. Hot chocolate. Yeah. Okay, sorry. That was corny. I know. Remember, guys, share this video. Everybody needs to be able to make a brownie like this. Okay? Mix these together good. You see that? It's looking like a brownie, isn't it? Oh, yeah. Okay? Now we're going to come over here with our caramel and butterscotch, okay? Coffee don't do anything for caramel and butterscotch, so we're just going to let them be, okay? We're going to add these in as well, but again, this cooled off, so we're not going to accidentally scramble our eggs. And, you know, when you're cooking this, if some of your chocolate chips or your caramel chips or whatever don't melt fully, it's not the end of the world. It's not like the brownie's gonna, what did I do? Okay. It's not like the brownie's gonna collapse or anything. You know what I mean? It's gonna cook, it'll melt. Oh, doesn't that look good? Ooh, oh, oh yeah. Oh yeah, I guess this is gonna be our blondie today, huh? I love blondies. Okay, now we're gonna go over to the dry ingredient station. Now, the dry ingredient station is where we add our flour, our salt, and baking powder. Now, what I want you to notice about the dry ingredients here is that we're not gonna use a ton of flour. And this recipe does not require a ton of flour because when we put this brownie together, we want it to be ooey gooey in the end. We want it to be ooey gooey. And so, Facebook fam, real quick note, Facebook fam, having a few technical difficulties. I can't communicate with you guys right now, but keep commenting, keep sharing, keep asking questions, keep tagging people. I will go back around and I'll make sure that I see all of your comments. Y'all talk to me because I get lonely when you don't talk to me. I do. Okay. So we're going to put 1/3 cup of flour is all you need in this recipe. And the reason you only need 1/3 cup is because it's almost, it's going to end up with, we want the ooey gooeyness in there. So to have ooey gooey, we cannot load it with flour. If we load it with flour, we won't get ooey gooey because it will bake. You just need a little bit of flour to hold the structure. Okay? So we're going to just use 1/3 cup of flour. And you'll notice I'm using my sifter, well, not quite sifter, my strainer, because this helps bring everything together, okay? And then we're also gonna use a little bit of baking powder because we want it to have a little bit of rise to it, right? Okay, and a little bit of salt because salt just enhances the flavor. I'm just using 1/2 teaspoon of salt, don't need a ton. The reason I like using this particular piece is I can do this, and this is mixing everything as it goes in. You see that? Seeing the salt sometimes is right there, so just turn over and dump it in. Okay, I need them to talk to me. I let that go. I need to talk to people. Y'all, we're having difficulties. At all? Uh-oh. Sorry, YouTube. We're just having difficulties. Okay, y'all. So I'm going to come right back over here, and we're going to do the same thing over here with the caramel one, okay? I'm going to get my 1/3 cup here, just like so. Should have got a bigger bowl, but that's okay. It's about right. So I'm gonna put that here, and I'm gonna get a little bit more. And of course, you know I gotta make a mess, y'all. Y'all know your girl got to make a little bit of a mess. Okay, and then we're gonna get again our baking powder this end, give it a nice little bit of rise. And we're gonna get some, again, a little bit of salt, because like I said, salt is just going to enhance the flavor. Okay, and same thing. Shake it up, baby. Okay, see that? And this you don't have to get out the sifter. I mean, I know I can't be the only person who hates getting the sifter out. Okay, we are having, so I'm glad that we've got the YouTube going over there because we're having connectivity problems, you guys, with our Wi-Fi. We are having Wi-Fi problems. Okay, but that's all right. You still with me, YouTube fam? Here we go. See, we're mixing this up, and if you know anything about brownie batter, you know this is just how it do what it do. Look at that. Oh, that's looking good. Okay, now what I'll do at this stage usually is I'll actually come away from the whisk and move over to one of my spoons, make sure I get everything out there, and this is the way I like to come at it. See that? Oh yeah, that's good. Okay, let's come over here, start the same thing. Mixing this one up. Can you see me? All right. Okay, oh yes. Don't y'all just love how in this day of technological advances, the simplest thing can go wrong and throw off our whole program? These things happen. Okay, there we go. See how we get it going? Then again, I'm gonna come in with one of these little doohickeys. Clear out our said whisk and just mix it up like so. See there? And you don't want to over mix this. You don't want to over mix it. You just want to make sure you've got everything incorporated. Okay, there we go. Looks good, huh, guys? Now, all we're gonna do is mix, put this into a cast iron skillet. Now, this is an 8-inch cast iron skillet. A 9-inch is probably a little bit better size because in the 8-inch, it's gonna cook up to the top. I happen to like that cooking up to the top. That's why I go ahead and use this one. I usually put just a little smidge of oil around the edges of it just so they'll be a little crispy. You don't have to because you're gonna scoop it out anyway, but just a smidge. See, I just put that little smidge in there and wipe it around. It just helps the ends be crispy. And this is olive oil I'm putting in there, but it really doesn't matter because I'm using such a small amount, it's not gonna do anything to the flavor. Nothing at all, okay? All right, there we go. And now we're gonna get our brownie mix into our cast iron. We're gonna start with this one. Oh, you guys, we forgot to taste the batter. What? Ooh, I'm gonna taste the batter here. Let's see. Mmm. Oh, this makes me happy. I'm so excited. Oh, that's good, okay. I tasted with this side. I'm gonna taste with this side, the chocolate one. Okay, let's see. Mmm. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, now, wow. Okay, the blonde one. I'm gonna add some toffee to this, a little bit of toffee before I fully mix it in, okay? These are just some loose toffee chips here, and I'm just gonna add this in just to give it a little more of that lightness, you know what I'm saying? There's really no particular reason to do this except if we're already going this far, we might as well go ahead on and finish, you know what I'm saying? Okay, we're gonna pour this in here, like so. And when you bake these, we're gonna bake them on 350 degrees for about 22 to 25 minutes. And the key with the baking is you don't need to bake it any longer than that unless you don't want it to be ooey gooey. If you want the center of it to be more done, then by all means, bake it 25, maybe even 30 minutes, okay? See this? Just like so. Spread it out. And anything extra on the top like that is for you to eat now. Or do like I do. I usually call the kids and say, brownie spoon, and they come running. Okay, I'm gonna add a couple more on the top of this. Oh yeah, this looks delicious. Oh man, you guys, I cannot wait. I've got some vanilla ice cream in there. We're gonna put on top of this when they come out. It's about to be on like popcorn. Okay, there's one. Now this other one here is the one that will be chocolate caramel. Now, actually you guys, I'm not gonna fully make it chocolate caramel. I hope you forgive me. Because, let me tell you, to make it chocolate caramel, you would just take a half a cup of caramel chips and stir them in. That's it, okay? But I kind of, you know I like to try things, right? I wanna make this a s'mores brownie. So I have these s'mores chips here. Okay, these are s'mores chips, and what I'm gonna do is put the s'mores chips in there and make it kind of like a s'mores brownie, because that just feels right in my heart. You understand me? In my heart, that feels right. I asked my heart, and my heart said yes, and I don't want my heart to think that I don't trust it. So, what you do, because this has chips and brown cookie brownies, all this stuff, I'm gonna put it in another bowl for a second. And I want to show you guys something. What you do is you take just a smidge of flour, okay? A smidge of flour and sprinkle just a little bit on there. Just a little bit, you don't need a lot, okay? That's like maybe a half a teaspoon, okay? And you just mix it around. You can use a spoon, or you see I just used a little. And the reason you're doing this is because you don't want these to sink to the bottom. Because when you bake it, you're gonna go to the bottom. So you put a little bit of flour, just a smidge, about a teaspoon. You don't need a lot. Okay, because you're not trying to thicken it, you're just trying to give it a little bit. And then I'm going to put these in. And again, this is about a half a cup here of these s'mores chips. And again, you can do this with caramel, so anything really. But I'm just going to stir them in, fold them in lightly. I'm not going crazy. You see, I'm just folding them in, just making sure they get covered so they're mixed in, right? And then we're going to put this in this one. Okay, I hope you can see me, guys. This is heavy. These glass bowls ain't no joke, boy. Let me get this sucker out. Oh, you guys, I can't wait. Now, you know the other good part about these is if you're entertaining or having like a dinner party or even if you're just you and your family are having it. What you can do is as soon as you finish eating dinner or whatever, you can pop these in the oven. And when either when you finish dinner or when everybody kind of finishes getting their plates put away or throwing, you know, whatever you do at the end of your dinner party, by the time you finish all that and sit down, it's time for dessert. And you, these will come out of the oven and they will be perfect. Okay, so I'm gonna take again these extra pieces here and I'm gonna just put them on the top here like this, just like so. I'm really trying to get these graham cracker pieces and these little marshmallows in here. That's what I really want on the top. Ooh, when I found these s'mores, bits or cooked chips thing, y'all, I got excited at the store. You know what I'm saying? You ever get excited at the grocery store, you see something, you're like, ah! And then you hope nobody saw you because then they're gonna think like you got a problem or something. That was me when I found these. If you wonder why I'm picking through it, it's because I'm really looking for the marshmallows and the graham cracker pieces. Because it's got chocolate all up in it. Okay, that's good. All right, now I'm just gonna, for safekeeping, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna leave good well enough alone. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna keep messing with it, I'm gonna mess it up. Okay, so you guys, that's what you do. You put those in the oven, and then, miraculously, it's a miracle, from above, ooh, it's still hot too. Okay, when it comes out of the oven, look at this. Look at that. When it first comes out, you see, it's all puffed up because it's a big brownie, right? But then what happens after a while, it sits and it settles, and I'm ready. I'm going to dig into it because I want you guys to see. You see that? Look at the middle. Look at that. You see that ooey gooey? I put peanut butter chips in this one. You see how ooey gooey that is? It's a little hot. It's not super, super hot. Can you see? I don't know if you guys can see. Look here. Show them. Let me turn this around. I went just on the edge because I'm trying not to mess it up yet. But I want you guys to see. Do you see the ooey? Do you see the gooey? You see that? Let me get another spoon. Oh, yeah. You see? See that? That's what you want. Now, if you want yours ooeyer and gooeyer, cook it less time. But if you want it all the way done, cook it more time. This was about 25 minutes I put it in. If you want it to be really gooey, then you can go less. The reason I don't go less than this generally is because then it's like a molten cake, which is okay. I have nothing against molten cakes. Nothing at all. Okay, I'm gonna taste it now. And see, when you get it out and it's fresh hot, you put the ice cream on top and it melts and then everybody can just like get a scoop. It's delicious. Cheers. I don't know what to say right now. Won't he do it? And let me tell you something. I told you I put peanut butter in this. I found some little Reese's Pieces chips and I stirred them in. Now, I didn't have to put flour on those Reese's Pieces things or Reese's chips or whatever because they're just little candies, but they melted. That's what you see here. See how they melted? See the little outside coat? They melted and you taste the peanut butter brownie. So what I want your takeaway. You can make a peanut butter brownie. You can make a coconut brownie. You put you can do anything you want. It's your thing. Do what you want to do. And I can't wait to eat it. So you guys, that is all for tonight. I hope you shared this video. If you forgot to share, there's still time. Share. If you did share it again because sharing is caring. Okay, guys, couple things also. Don't forget fried chicken class. If you're local to the DMV area, we'll be teaching fried chicken, how to fry the perfect chicken, next Saturday, June 30th at Williams-Sonoma in Mosaic. That's in Fairfax. So please call the store. The information's on my page. Call the store. Reserve your spot. Can't wait to see you there. It is a cost to it, but you also get to hang out with me. Okay. And you get a takeaway. You get either a fried basket or a thermometer for the oil. So it's going to be a lot of fun, you guys. I can't wait. It's going to be good. You know, y'all know how I'm not going to let you down. You know? Okay, yesterday we were on Good Morning Washington doing burger makeover. Check out that link as well as on the page. I will see you guys next week, same time, same place, right here, back in the Love Lab for more Calabama cooking. I need to go back and talk to the Lord about this brownie some more. Okay, guys, love you. Happy cooking.